Okay, XYZ is the overlap part. The area of figure 2 is now 7 over 12 the area of figure 1. So that means this 7 is actually 4, figure 2, which is 7 units. And this 12 is for figure 1, which is 12 units. So we can change, see that from 12 units, it actually became 7 units in figure 2. Why? Because there's a change in 5 units, right? Because 12 units minus 5 units, you get 7 units. Why is there a decrease? It's due to the overlapping region. Okay, I'm going to use a highlighter to mark up the overlapping region. So you can see that this part and this part. So you can see that the X became here. So upon folding, right, you can see that now this is the part that actually overlaps with this part. You fold in your mind, you can see. Okay, so now you need only have this region, which is originally here, this region, which is originally here, and this is actually these two regions. You can see from here, it's actually these two regions. So since there's a minus 5 unit, I would know that each of this region must be 5 units, right? Now that it overlap, that's why there's a decrease in 5 units. Okay, if the total area of the unshaded part is actually 54. So we know that unshaded part is actually 12 units minus away the shaded part, which is 10 units, right? And this is equals to 54. You also know that 2 units equals to 54 cm squared. I can conclude that 1 unit is actually equals to 54 divided by 2, which is 27 cm squared. Now that you know what is 1 unit, we are supposed to find the area of the rectangular piece of paper in figure 1. So the entire area is 12 units. So 12 units equals to 27 multiplied by 12. And what would that give us? You can use your calculator. 27 multiplied by 12. That will give you 324 cm squared. Let me move this a little bit higher. You'll get 324 cm squared.